Well, hi guys. It's wet and nasty outside. So I've come up today to start getting ready to put my new hoses together. One of the things I need to do is make this bracket fit the tractor, and it's to get it bent down, so easy to do. And there you have it. Let's give that. Just a taste more. There you have that. Come over to my handy dandy bolt bin. For a bolt. Now it's ready to go on the tractor. So, let me get you back over here. Comes in a kit with all the bolts and stuff, but I don't need to take it out because I'm not ready to use it. But I can put that back in, and it's ready to go. So, we'll be back here in a moment with part two. Hang on. Okay, guys. I've got two new 60-inch hoses for the 1850 to replace the ones that are bad, have brass ends. I'm going to get myself more ready for the job when I can do it. So we're going to go ahead and pre-assemble the hose ends so I don't have to think about it. They're ready to go. So I don't spend a lot of time for nothing. These are Pioneer ends. Fortunately, I didn't want to buy the tips, but I got to do that anyway. Always love these. Now the upper end here is a non-swivel. The swivel end's on the other end where it's going to hook to the tractor. And I always save these caps Because you never know when you might need that little rascal for something else. I like that idea better. Somehow. This seems to be a better idea. Yes, you can over tighten things, but I don't think I've got there yet. Some may say, oh, that's good. That's going to be a little trickier. But we'll get it whipped. Okay, now that's done. Now I have two hoses that are long enough to go on the tractor this way, be looped around the axle, and long enough to go to the back of the tractor to go into that bracket. As you see, it's got an end on it. So, both ends are done now. So that makes my job, when I go to put them on the tractor, a little bit easier. And these are the hook under pressure ends. So, I'm gonna call it quits for here for now, because they're done, they're ready to go on the tractor. It's too cold, it's wet and nasty. It's only about 45 degrees out, so I'm gonna wait till tomorrow when it's in the 60s to come up and do this. So we'll see you then, guys. So hang on, we'll be back here in just a moment. Hang on. Oh, hi guys, it's Wednesday, the 18th, I believe, of March. I'm getting into the 1850 to change these hoses. And I've come up with something very peculiar. The oil coming out of the hydraulics is red. Not good. Almost makes me feel like somebody got confused, put hydraulic oil in the hydropower and transmission fluid in the hydraulics. Don't know. I got one hose undone from the coupler. I'm going to see if I can get the other one undone. I'm going to have to put them down on the floor to drain out, because I got to unscrew them from back there. So be back here in just a bit, guys. Hang on. Okay. if we get these off. Oh shit, that wasn't even tight. Red oil. Really not what I was expecting to find. But, might just use that to fold again. And I'm going to save them because, well, somebody just might want them. Might use this bolt again, too. Let's put it up here. Let's see. This hose is twisted up. It's gonna be fun no matter what I do to it. Oh, good grief. Something tells me I'm gonna have to unscrew that end. For some reason, oh good God, it ain't moving. Okay. Yep, I'm going to have to take the swivel off. No way around it. Okay, complicates things a little bit. But, it is what it is. So we'll be back here in a moment, guys. Okay, I've managed to get them off the tractor. It's a nice hydraulic fitting. Date stamp there, it looks like. But, well, that's loose. God. was afraid of. What I was afraid of. Rounded right around it. Yeah, I should have just thrown everything on the floor, I guess. So, go with plan B. This might work, I don't know. We'll find out. Well, I'm going to have to take it back and put it in the vise and see if I can break it loose. I need to fit it. But we'll be back here in a minute, guys. Okay, guys. I've got one hose on there. And we'll stick the other one on now. Yesterday's work made this easier. But it's pretty straightforward. Just a pain in the butt to tighten it up. There ain't a whole lot of room there. Course. But at least these are swivel ends, which makes it a lot easier. It's in such a dang place to get to. Full of nice things to bust your knuckles on. There we go. There we go! Now, that's where this might, I don't know, oh, of course not. Good thing we got the handy dandy adjustable. I can move that back just a little bit. Okay. And as you can hear, we're getting some more lovely spring showers. Like we really need those. Okay. Good enough. Let's see if it takes this apart.
Yep.
Yes. Yes. Oh, yes, it does. Yeah, what do you need to do? It snugged up in a way where it'll hold itself. Now, it looks like what it might have to be. That may have to be the way it has to be, like it or not. Sometimes these can be a pain in the butt. That's what this is being, a pain in the butt. Thank you. It's not exactly what I want right there. As you can see, I really don't want that hose going around the other hose like it is. But because of the nipple here fitting, bringing it out farther than the front, doesn't give me a lot of choice. Well, I guess it's just going to be that way. Not exactly what I want, but they're relaxed enough, and it does move some, so I have to keep an eye on it. But that gets the hydraulics more relaxed, and it's got to be better than what it just was. With that all wrapped up around itself. So I may not like it, but I'll take it. Beggars can't be choosy, so I'm not going to be too choosy about it. Okay. Go get a couple of washers. I'll be right back. Okay, guys. Last couple of bolts just in tight. And there we have it. Perfect? Nope. But
It'll work.
Those are loose. So, I'm going to call this a success. Some may say I'm crazy for the way I just routed these, for buying the extra length of hose, but when you come out, you either got to make a hard bend like this and come in, which no matter how hard you try, keeps those hoses cocked all the time. Or you get a mess like was on it. They're all defumbled. Now you can get a hold of it, it's loose. It's loose. And you can move it. But that gives us 4 new hydraulic hoses and ends put on this. Those old brass ends have been replaced. And the Oliver ends are now, they're good. I just literally don't have a use for them because I don't have the ends that go on them. But I think I'm going to call it here. It's pouring rain out. And I've got some other work to do at home. So we'll call this a job successfully done. And it's in, it's on, it's in good shape. Now, at some point, I've got to take this plug out and adjust the clutch. When I'll do that, I don't know. But the next thing that happens to this, well, it's already been done. We'll see it. So, we'll see you next time, guys. And as always, please comment, rate, and subscribe. Even on a rainy day, I got things I can do. So we'll see you next time.